Today's problem is all about design. It's about designs such as these printed T-shirts. The design on the T-shirt I'm wearing is called a logo. In fact, it's a logo for our programme, Micro Mind Stretchers. Now, you can use personal designs or logos in all sorts of places, not just on T-shirts. For instance, you could make your own greetings cards like these, which you could send to family or friends. Or you could design a special cover for your books so that everybody knows who they belong to. Now, it's not easy to make a good personal design, so we've been to see a professional designer, Jonathan Inglis, to get some tips on how to make a start. A good way to start is to base the design on your initials. Jonathan's are JMI.
One thing that's always a good idea is to put some kind of backing frame. So I'm going to use, to start with, just an oval like this, which I fill in. And now I'm going to put my initials over the top. Don't just do them in a straight line. Really think about how you can make the design look a bit more interesting. When I'm working on a design, I tend to work very quickly, trying out all sorts of different ideas, just so that I've got a page of work that I can look at and perhaps get some ideas from that. Working with conventional paper and pencil like this is a very time-consuming process.
If you're not very careful, you're going to end up with an awful lot of different versions and using up an awful lot of paper and time. What I need is a machine that takes the drudgery out of drawing. What I need is a computer. What I'm going to start by doing is by doing the backing frame here. When you plan your design, it's worth remembering that it's very important to have a good balance between blocks of colour and lines. If you just use all lines, the results tend to look a little bit weedy. This is one of the things I really like about using a computer. No more messy filling in with paint or felt tip. All I do is one click of the button and I'm back with a full area. Now I'm going to change the colour so that I'm going to draw in red on my green background. Drawing with a computer isn't as easy as drawing with a pen or pencil. And drawing curved lines is particularly fiddly. So it's always worth remembering to try and draw with straight lines. You can soon build up the idea of a curve just by shortening your straight lines like this. When I've saved the first version of this picture that I've done, I can begin to make a few changes without losing that first version, which is stored safely on disk, so that if I want to add a few lines, I can. I don't need to redraw the picture. If I find that I've made a mistake and I'm not very happy, I can change them. No redrawing, no need to trace. That's the great beauty of a computer.
Many of Jonathan's designs have been published in glossy magazines. When am I gonna make a living? Ooh, it's gonna take a while before I give in. And to get you thinking about your own logo, here are a few simpler designs. Professional designer Jonathan Inglis using a computer similar to the kind you have in school. Now, this T-shirt has been printed with one of his black and white designs and then coloured in with fabric paints. And that brings us back to our problem. How can you use a computer to help you create your own personal designs and logos? And remember, keep it simple.